You don't have any other of interaction, just the passage of wave. But what happens when an interface is encountered? We observe that we have the so-called energy partition at interface. The seismic waves are reflected, parts are reflected, other parts are refracted, diverged down, and also converted from B to S, and also from S to B. So at the interface, we have the waves converting from primary to secondary, and also from secondary to primary, if we are propagating in solids. But if we are propagating in liquids, for example, for marine seismic experiment, we are not expecting to have reflected shear waves, because it cannot reflect, it cannot propagate in seawater. Okay, the reflection is governed by reflection coefficient, which represent the percentage of the energy that will be reflected. So if I suppose that the incident energy is 1, so reflection energy represent the percentage of this energy that will be reflected up. The relation, this one is the represents the energy partition. We have 2 interfaces with VB1, VS1, rho 1, and VB2, VS2, and rho 2. We have incident B wave, reflected S, reflected B, and also transmitted S and transmitted B, obeying Snell law and law of reflection. Reflection coefficient is defined by this relation, Z2 minus Z1, where Z2 is the elastic impedance of the second medium, and Z1 is the elastic impedance of the first medium. So it's Z2 minus Z1 divided by Z1 plus Z2. Okay? So, if this is a percentage of the energy that will be reflected, can you tell me, Yvonne, what is the percentage of refracted energy? Suppose you are in an interview now and you have this question. So tell me, any guess you have? 15? Why? Okay, Atiq. Yes. Okay. Taqi. If it's half, why are you estimating reflection coefficient and so on? What is the use of estimating reflection coefficient? If it's half. Yes. Okay. If the percentage of energy that will be reflected is R, then the transmission energy will be 1 minus R. So we have 100%. We understand that 70% will be reflected. Okay, then only 30% will be refracted. right or wrong? So we should use our tools. We have some tools here, and so we should use it and think. It's not all only, do not depend only on memorizing, but you have to think. This graph, schematic view of what happens in reflection. This is the law of reflection. The angle of incidence equals the angle of reflection. And this one is the Snell law, which represents, which says that the sine of incident angle divided by the sine of refracted angle equal V1 divided by V2. And this relation, the Snell law, is very one of the pillar of seismic method. As I told you, for ray tracing, we use this relation to define the ray parameter. The ray parameter is like your name. It's like the name of the ray. So this ray has a parameter B1, B2, B3, B, and so on. So this is one of the pillar laws for seismic, together with Fermat, Bath, and together with Hamilton equation, and so on. So we'll end our discussion today by the basic law of for seismic refraction. We'll focus on two important laws, Snell law and reciprocity law. Snell law states that sine of incident angle divided by the sine of refracted angle equal the ratio between V1 and V2. Okay? What state is very important for seismic refraction experiment? It says, primarily refraction method depends on the hypothesis that velocity increase with depth, and we'll know now why. This is because refracted waves to be recorded by an array of G-phones on the surface should be critically refracted. Critically refracted means that it must refract with an angle equal 90 degrees from the normal to the interface, meaning that the ray moves parallel to the interface itself with the velocity of the second layer, of the higher layer, higher velocity layer. And then it acts as an incident ray with angle 90 degrees. It will refract back to the surface with the critical angle of incidence and then record it back on the surface. The propagation parallel to the interface is called head waves. And this figure will show us the situation. Here, sorry, the arrowhead is not right. The incidence here, this is the IC angle of critical angle of refraction, which result in we have 90 degree refraction in the second media. This ray act as ray incident at the interface with the angle equal 90 degree, which means it will refract back to the surface with an angle IC. This is the case for flat horizontal interface. This part is called head waves. We are interested in this type because as V2 is greater than V1, we have this situation and we have energy traveling back to the surface and then recorded. In other case, when V1 is greater than V2, angles move, the increase in the incident angle is more than the increase in the refracted angle, and so we don't have angle of 90 degree refraction. We don't have, in this case, heat wave. So all the energy in this case will be lost and will not come up and record on the surface. And here we have what's called a low velocity layer or blind, because we cannot see this velocity. If we have smaller velocity layer, then this is not encountered, is not seen completely on the seismic curve. This is our case when V2, this V2 equal to V1. So it means V2 is greater than V1. As the angle of incidence increases, the angle of refraction increase more. Okay. Finally, we speak about the principle of reciprocity. The travel time of seismic energy between any two points is independent of the direction it travels, which means that putting the geophone here and shooting from here is equal to putting the geophone here and shoot from other side, which means the total travel time or the collection of travel time. No. The collection of travel time, the travel time at any point from two shots at the same position, at the same distance, should be the same. This is a schematic view. Shooting from there and recording here, we have time T1, and reversing, we have time T2, so T1 equal T2. In travel time distance curve, we can say that the total travel time for forward shooting equal to total travel time for reverse shooting. Okay, we stop here. Tomorrow, inshallah, we'll try to find some solution to this oven, and also continue our discussion. Okay, thank you.